Like many hunters, you may be concerned about the potential impacts of eating CWD-positive venison on your family's health. Research investigating whether CWD can spread to humans is still ongoing and takes a long time. Scientists can't purposely infect humans with diseases, so animal models are used for research. Studies with CWD in animals, such as rodents, primates, and pigs, have shown conflicting results. In some cases, animals became infected with CWD, but not always. Additionally, another prion disease, mad cow disease in cattle, has infected humans who consumed meat from positive animals. So public health officials suggest we avoid eating meat from CWD-positive deer to keep CWD prions out of the human food chain. Ultimately, it is a personal choice whether or not to eat venison from CWD-positive animals. However, keep in mind that research has shown that 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit will not destroy the prions that cause CWD, so cooking your venison well done at 150 degrees Fahrenheit will not protect you from the risk of CWD. Public health officials recommend hunters should consider testing deer from areas where CWD has been detected. CWD prions can spread from sick deer carcasses to uninfected meat during processing. So if you process your own deer, make sure that you process each deer individually, package and label the venison separately, and clean the area and all equipment well before processing a new deer. This way, when you get your CWD results, you can make an informed decision about if you want to eat the meat. The safest choice for your family's health is to not eat venison from a CWD-positive deer. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more videos on CWD and deer.